Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up.
I've worked so hard for this.
I don't even know if he wants to invest.
What a chicken.
You called me a chicken. You attacked me.
If the pitch fails...
You guys ready to vote? That is four no's. Send them down.
Going down.
But if the pitch is successful...
That's four yeses. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the
elevator pitch. Let's go!
Sounds like a deal.
Awesome.
Is the next billion-dollar idea on its way up? This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
All right, guys, who's ready to make some money? Let's hear the first pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Amanda Gorman, and my company, Nest Collaborative, is a healthcare technology company that's disrupting women's health by providing breastfeeding support virtually. See, breastfeeding saves lives, reducing diseases like cancer, diabetes, heart disease, and sudden infant death. So 80% of moms try to do it, but 70% fail. And this costs the US over $13 billion annually in healthcare costs directly related to their failure. Our online video visits are covered at 100% by payers with no out-of-pocket costs. We're contracted with six national payers who've paid us on over 150 visits to date with a 52% margin. We're looking for $500,000 under a convertible note with a $4 million cap for strategic partnership development, operations, and tech enhancements to penetrate this $40 billion market. As a nurse practitioner and a mother who struggled to breastfeed, I know firsthand how difficult postpartum can be. We're making it better and saving lives. Please join us.
She was smooth.
Wow, she was good.
That was really good.
She did.
Yeah, she did. She was articulate. She nailed that one.
What's the business?
Not sure.
Okay, well, let's hear. I think I won.
We don't have to all say yes.
Kind of want to find out.
Well, we know what's to do with breastfeeding.
Yes. I think we have our decision made, so let's vote.
Okay, three yeses and one no. So let's open the doors. Find out more.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Thank you very much. Hi.
Hello. Hi.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Amanda, we have to say, and part of this literally of being a good entrepreneur is just the pitch, and you nailed the pitch.
Thank you.
However, we're not exactly sure what you're selling and what this is. So maybe you could elaborate more.
Sure. So my company is expanding access to affordable healthcare for women, specializing in lactation support, which is breastfeeding support, which we're performing virtually.
I take it breastfeeding longer stops postpartum depression?
Much better. So a woman who breastfeeds for at least 12 months cuts her risk of getting ovarian cancer and breast cancer in half. She also cuts her chances of heart disease. We're cutting down leukemias, diabetes.
And how much revenue are you doing now?
So we launched in earnest in February with a very small direct-to-consumer marketing campaign in three states. Our budget was very limited, and this was just paid in organic search. And that revenue was only about $3,000. But we are fairly far along with a strategic investor, and we have not settled on the exact terms, but I'm leaving room for that.
So you think the strategic will...
Based on their deals that they typically do, they come in typically around $250 to $500.
$250 to $500. And are they going to set the price, and this is just a predetermined price?
So we've had that discussion. They're comfortable with a $4 million cap.
I just want to make sure that I understand one thing. Is it content that a person that's having an issue or something like that, a woman with the breastfeeding, that they're coming to see the content and it's more of a subscription? Or is it that you are connecting them with a live person that is starting it from the get-go and then playing a role? It's just remote versus them having to go to a physical location, and you're just the actual provider, and you just will have a network of people across the country to do
that. Exactly. It's structured as if mom is walking into an office, providing her insurance information, scheduling the appointment, filling out the paperwork, her medical history. We are just doing this virtually. So she's able to connect from her home, from her couch, from her car. Our biggest differentiator is payer reimbursement, direct payer reimbursement. We take no payment from mom directly.
I think it's a great business. My only problem is I wouldn't want to set the valuation. I would have like to come in behind the strategic investor. They've obviously done tons of due diligence. They're in negotiations. I don't want to set the marker on, they're comfortable with $4 million. Is that investment subject to other money? Are they prepared to move forward even?
No, they're willing to come in as a lead. Is there a number that you'd be willing to come in at as a follow-on?
I mean, at least 250 to 500, right?
So let's recap. What are we doing?
So what we're willing to offer is that we will consider the $250,000 to $500,000 investment at those terms.
Okay. I think that's fair. I'd like to accept it.
Good.
Great.
Congratulations. Yeah.
Thank you so much, guys. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Great job.
So I think they like the pitch, and I think they're interested in following on after a strategic investor with the ask, if I can produce a lead investor myself. I'm happy with how I did. I didn't stutter, so that was good.
Okay, moving on. Let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
How you guys doing? My name is Giacomo Hakim. I'm the CEO and founder of Tailored Club. What is Tailored Club? The Uber of custom tailoring. Anyone and everyone from around the world can buy this business in a bag for $299. It's an MLM model so they can get more people to join. And the process is very simple. They go to people's homes and offices, they measure them up quickly. We've automated the business and very innovative, so they take the order online and the customer receives the product in 2 to 3 weeks. We make custom suits, custom shirts, custom denim, custom shoes, custom belts, custom ties. I dress all the anchors on Fox News and CBS. I'm actually booked for the segment over there on the 1st, that's Entrepreneur Week. We also just did a trunk show on the Royal Caribbean ships and we killed it. I'm actually going there tomorrow to see how many more ships we can get on. I'm seeking a $2.5 million investment, convertible note at a $25 million valuation.
That ask is crazy.
I have an Excel sheet over here to show you how we can make $30 million in 24 months.
Time's up. Good looking suit.
This guy better have a lot of revenue going on right now.
I like his idea.
I like his idea too.
He's definitely got some clients, but he didn't say what kind of revenue he has.
So he has a person that's actually going out to do the measurements.
No, he's selling an MLM. So for $299, you can buy all of this stuff at wholesale, and then you can also sell it to other people. It's just like Amway, right? So if I sell to you, you can sell it to a whole bunch of people, so you can get your own clients and sell suits and ties right off of the app.
Okay.
Or sell them a franchise.
Be interesting to see the margins and who's doing the production on the back end, manufacturing.
So I guess we got to vote.
All right, let's vote.
Looks like that's four yeses. Let's open the doors and hear what this $25 million man's all about.
Let's see it.
Welcome to the
boardroom.
Let's
make some money. Hey, guys.
Hello.
How you doing?
Okay,
ready to invest in the next billion-dollar company?
We have a question.
Sure.
You have a monster ask of $2.5 million at a $25 million valuation. What's your revenue last year, and what do you project this year?
Okay, so I've only been in business for 6 months now, and we've done around $500,000 in sales. I have a bit over 50 agents now. And I'm sure you guys are familiar with the network marketing business, MLM. It multiplies and scales and grows. So the goal, I'm seeking $2.5 million with the plan to go out and just do marketing and advertising to gain an extra 2,500 agents with that $2.5 million. If you run the numbers on that, that means my cost of acquisition per agent is $1,000. So I'm basically paying $1,000 to get you to give me $300 to buy into this business. So I'm lowballing that as well. And once...
Appreciate the lowball.
Yeah. If each agent only does $1,000 a month in sales, which is, once again, a big lowball, that's $2.5 million a month. By the way, remember, I don't know if I mentioned this, it's also for women.
That's what I was hoping.
Oh, yeah. So
yeah.
We make custom suits for women as well.
Who do you have agreements with on the back end? Like, who's the manufacturer?
So it's family-owned, the back end.
What did you do before this?
I was a DJ.
You're a DJ?
Yeah, I was.
Wow.
I truly believe that most entrepreneurs don't make bad decisions, they make bad assumptions. And I think you're making a bad assumption when you say, well, if only 1,000, if each of those sales, that's a bad assumption. And you can't make that assumption yet because you haven't done the work to get there.
Okay, but I have 50 agents right now, and I'm doing around 80,000 a month.
So what does that annualize? 80,000 a month right now. That'd be about $1 million,
exactly.
Right? You are asking for 25 times your current revenue.
On a convertible note, though.
Doesn't matter, it's a convertible note. Converts to equity.
My personal belief is you've skipped a few steps to prove your business model, and it's far too expensive.
The problem is, I think it's just premature. I don't need to make a big speech of it. It's too early for me. You're only 6 months into this thing. You're getting great traction. You don't have a proven track record. It is just way too big of an ask, and I don't know how you can structure something that has any merit at this time.
Okay.
Yeah. Great concept. Great.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
So we do have one question. Out of all the clothes that you have in your kit, do they not have socks?
Yeah, this is the look, man. The
look. Good luck.
Thank you, guys. Yeah. All the best.
Good luck.
Very impressive.
Thank you. Yeah.
Stick with it.
Thank you. I went in there, I gave my pitch. They said they liked the project, but they thought I was asking for too much money. The first one to give me $2.5 million will be laughing to the bank. I'm very confident that I'll take this company somewhere. Just wasn't meant to be with them.
Let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
70% of kids are walking away from organized youth sports by the age of 13. That's totally unacceptable. Experts say it's caused by three primary reasons: the pressure to win, the pressure to personally achieve, and the lack of coaching at the college, or the high school or youth level. Youth Sports Media was designed to fill that void. We're creating transformational content that inspires and educates players, parents, and coaches at the youth level. Over 40 elite coaches like Dave Roberts, the manager of the Los Angeles Dodgers, have joined our mission and our staff to educate these families.
Come on, guys. Oh, you can do it. Come on. Keep going. You got time. Oh, man, he's blowing it. He is blowing it. Come on, he's got to recover. Come on. Don't blow
Make
it.
Make a comeback, man.
Dude, come on, you're in sports.
There's 372 million players, parents, and coaches across the globe that could benefit from our content. We invite you to join our mission.
Time's up.
We're seeking an investment from...
This guy. Wow.
You know what I like about when this happens, though, is we forget here how hard that is.
Yeah. It's like
we talk about how easy it is to pitch.
Yeah.
But you sit in the elevator with all those cameras on you, and you practice and practice, and he was nailing it.
Maybe just give him like a, give him a line.
He's out.
Oh, you're already
we're
out?
Deliberating, yeah. He's done. He said, fuck. And he walked off.
Oh, I thought we were going to let him go again.
No, that's the rules. You can't go again.
We can't do a duel zone on this
There's
guy?
There's no crying in baseball.
Wait, we're supposed to decide based on that?
Yes. Yes. There's
Kim,
no crying.
I am with you.
No crying in baseball, and you can't go again. Enough is enough. Time to vote. Okay, that's four no's. Let's set him down.
Going down.
I looked at the clock, and I felt that I was behind, and I brain locked. Baseball doesn't have a clock. It's the only sport that actually doesn't have a clock. So, unfortunately, I looked at the clock and panicked, I guess.
And now, perfecting the pitch from Sprint Business.
What is the outline of this business?
Outline your business model. Your business model tells an investor how your product or service will be economically viable. It should answer these questions. What do you sell? Who do you sell it to? How much does it cost? And how do customers pay you?
Questions answered.
Sprint Business works for business. Check out sprint.com/elevator pitch.
Hopefully I could still deal with the judges and be able to show them what we're doing and the strategy that we have to take this thing to the App Store and take it to the next level to give to business owners. I'm excited. I'm pumped up.
All right, let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
You know what's worse than driving in LA's traffic? Is being misled by fake reviews. It's frustrating because people and third-party companies take advantage of the top review sites by providing fake reviews that influence millions of people on where to go and what to buy. Just ask Aisha Curry. Her restaurant received tons of one-star reviews by salty NBA fans before her restaurant even opened. This is a nationwide problem that could make or break a business until now. My name is Jamel Robinson, co-founder of Malini, a local guide app giving you a review with a view. Malini displays 15-second verified video reviews shared by customers to help you discover the best restaurants, places to go, and shop without second-guessing reviews recommended. We're disrupting the $20 billion review market with our patent-pending online bodyguard that's powered by AI, which prevents fake reviews at the front door. We're seeking $300,000 for 10% equity to go to our marketing and sales. We could reshape the review market so the world could see it to believe it.
Time's up.
That was a sweet pitch.
Yeah, he did do good on his pitch.
So it's basically video reviews that he's certifying it's a trusted source.
Problem is, can you truly manipulate that system as well? Why can't you just manipulate that system?
Giving reviews, like a video review. Yeah, I mean, you could, theoretically.
Like that example he gave, the person who had negative reviews, why wouldn't those people just give 15 negative reviews? They're not afraid of some famous basketball player's wife. No, I'm serious. Like, what stops you from giving a video negative review? Then you have more credibility for being negative.
Good point, good point.
Okay, do we want to vote? You guys ready to vote?
Yeah,
let's vote. Okay, that is four no's. Let's send them down.
Going down.
Man, I felt like I gave my best shot at, you know, sharing what I'm doing and within my pitch, but I guess the judges saw that my product wasn't great enough to get on the show. So we're launching our private beta, and pretty much we're looking to take the App Store by storm.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hello, investors. My name is Micah Dyer. I've spent my entire career working with brands like Starbucks, Domino's, and Dick's Sporting Goods. It's been my job to keep their facilities operating. More specifically, they call me to fix their air conditioners, refrigerators, and ovens. Because every business needs these services, it shouldn't surprise you that my industry is worth over $200 billion each year. So why am I here? My blue-collar industry is plagued with high costs, poor customer service, and outdated technology. Just ask Greg or Don about their R&M hassles. That's why I launched OpenWrench, the industry's very first service mechanical company that leverages the on-demand gig economy. My customers
like
this
love idea. This.
In fact, I have two signed agreements worth over $6 million in revenue. I know with my knowledge and network, combined with your expertise, we can build a billion-dollar company.
Five.
I'm seeking $600,000 for 40% of my company.
One.
Thank you.
Time's up.
That is a big equity give up. So what does this technology do? I don't know if I fully caught that.
I don't either.
It's a marketplace.
It was a marketplace.
That's what I'm thinking. That you connect. That you would connect
fixers.
The fixers. Yeah, the fixers and the problems.
Yeah, on-demand
for
marketplace.
Commercial appliances.
For commercial.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because he's naming big box stores as an example.
Because there's a big one called Service Titan for residential for individuals, and then they have other ones that are more for commercial for large buildings. It sounds like that's what he's doing.
It was a good pitch.
It was a really good pitch. Very calm. Very succinct.
Okay, let's vote.
Four yeses, let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yes, let's do this. Awesome.
Hello.
Awesome. Hey.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Great to meet you.
Yes. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Appreciate it. How are you guys?
Good.
Good firm handshake.
Great pitch. Billions went off the page.
That's right. $200 billion industry. It does kind of go off the page.
We have some questions for clarification. Yeah. So your two signed contracts for $6 million.
Yep.
So are you generating revenue now, or that's?
I am generating revenue now. So I call it a soft launch. Maybe last week we started taking calls.
How does this work? Who are you connecting them?
So my app, the platform that I'm trying to build, would actually connect them directly to a technician rather than to a company. And so the technician goes out, performs the call, invoices it all through the app, just like they do today, except instead of paying the high cost of a company middleman, it goes directly to the technician.
So is it like a marketplace?
It's exactly like Uber. There's tons of technicians would be on the network, ready to take a call. One would show up nearby them. They would go and run that call through the app.
Uber for technicians?
Right.
So what do you need for the $600,000?
So for $600,000, I need to build the platform. Getting these technicians on board is actually fairly easy once you have the app, because I can interview them, I can train them, and getting customers on board is easy as well once the app is there.
But it's not built?
It's not built.
And is it just you, or are there others
involved? Today it's just me and a single tech in Arizona.
I think you should find a co-founder that's a technical person, and maybe even one other person that has another skill set within this whole space. Two or three co-founders, I think for us to invest, or at least for me to invest, I would want to see that team in place. You need people that are going to own this. Then I think a $600,000 ask won't have to be at 40. You're giving up 40% because you don't have a co-founder. And what you're basically telling us is, right, be my sort of co-founder. We're not going to be your right co-founder.
I don't disagree with you. I definitely would.
So have you been trying to do that?
I've been trying to do
that. That's your point. You just have not been successful?
I need a bigger boat. I agree with you.
You can't build a boat
until you have the captain and the skipper and all the different people.
I do agree with you. I guess what I'm saying is I'm a great captain. This is an industry that I've been in forever. I'm very well known. And
unfortunately, we need to call this one.
Yeah. Sorry, yeah. I'm passionate.
No, we love the passion, but I agree. Keep us posted. Great pitch. You too.
Yes.
Yeah.
Went and met with the investors in the boardroom, and they had some valuable feedback. They think that I need a co-founder and start to build a team before I can start taking an investment.
Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Cannabis consumers need to use multiple appliances.
Instapot for pot.
This might go up in smoke.
And to apply for season 5, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.